I want to show you today a demonstration on how to use the weightlifting app. The app is now launched from 10 days. I think the launch day was 10 April this month on the iOS, and the Android it's available from last week. It passed 10 days and already more than 1,000 people using this app, and I want to show you a demonstration for those who are new or don't see my last video where I show you how to use the app. The app, I want it to be very easy to use and very simple. Have the option also to track your training, and if you want after 2-3 months or month to see in the back, to see what you're doing the training, to have this opportunity. This also I want to speak about that because it's very important. If you use the app right, program from the app, they go ongoing. This means that they will adapt every month, and these changes and this adaptation, it will be about the feedback that I will receive after you use the application. So if you use right and you type there exactly what you do, I will see that, and I will see how much you can accomplish from the training. If you do too much, if you are finishing the training too fast, I can see all of this info into this app. So I will show you today, we'll jumping into the app. I will show you the 3 days weightlifting. You go weekly schedule, you go in day one. First time when you go in day one, I will recommend you to see all the training, what you need to do. So we have a muscle snatch with overhead squats. We have five sets. We work 40% and 50% of one rep max of your snatch. But here I will recommend you to don't use your all-time snatch PR, and it's better to use your current. So if your current is lower than your all-time, it's good to use your current one rep max. After that, we'll have an off-it snatch. Here same, we'll have three sets up to 70% of our one rep max in current snatch. After that, high bar back squats and snatch pull. It's good that almost, but soon it will be at all exercise. You have the video on how to perform the exercise. So if you don't, you can easily tap on the exercise and you will see the video with the explanation what you need to do. So after I see the program, what I need to do, start your warm up. It's better to make a warm up, to make a 10-15 minutes warm up. I will add also in the app a warm up routine, but that I recommend every time, and I recommend also to my online athletes that I work. I recommend also to my online athletes is that it's better to find your own warm up and to see where you have mobility problems. Because you, if you follow my warm up routine, maybe you have another problems in your personally, I longer period to warm up better my lower back and my hamstrings because they're very tight. Maybe you'll have problem at your ankles, or maybe you'll have problem at your shoulders. So I need to take care of these parts that I don't stay too much at my shoulders, for example, because my shoulders are very good, are very mobile, and I don't had too much problems with shoulders in the past, and that's why it's good to use your own warm up. But I will show you. There will be a general warm up, and after that you can reach and to adapt after your own needs. After you complete the warm up, it's simpler because you only need to type here start workout,
five,
and in 5 seconds.
Four. 3, 2, 1.
From now on,
go.
Also the app, it will track how much time you will spend to make the training, and I recommend you to make all the training, and after you'll finish the training to see also how much time it's all taking. I will see also myself how much in the average how much time you will spend to make the warm up. I will do now the first set. This was the first set. After I complete the set, I tap here on the
break.
This key.
Track your progress.
And you have the option to track your progress. Here you can switch. If you do more reps or less, I will recommend you to type exactly what you do. So I was doing 5 muscle snatch and 3 overhead squats. I do this one to make a 2 minutes pause, and I have a 1:30 left. And we'll continue like that.
Five, four, three, two, one, go.
finished the second set. I will do here the same. I will track the progress.
Track your progress.
If you feel something bad and it's not going well, also you have the option here to add some notes, so you can write here whatever you feel or whatever you want to remember in the future, like barbell was feeling heavy or was feeling easy, or you feel that low back was tight, or your hamstring or everything else, and you save it. And you'll have at each set you'll have a 2 minutes pause between them. I'll recommend you to take that pause because it's good at your central nervous system to fully recover. Finished also the third set.
Break. Track your progress.
Now we'll need to go at 50% of our max snatch and work there. Two sets, four reps at muscle snatch, two at overhead squats, and this we'll do for two sets. Here though, don't forget, for example, if you need to go at 50%, and let's say
track
muscle
progress.
Snatch, you only can make three reps. I'll recommend you to, even if the program is written to do four reps, if you only can make three reps, I'll recommend you to put exact amount that you perform in training. That way, it will help me also. You'll help me also when I will see the completion and the accuracy of the training.
We'll skip
now. We'll go to the next exercise, and it's no-fit snatch. And we can jump directly into no-fit snatch because muscle snatch and overhead squat, it's very similar like a no-fit snatch, but it's from two movements. So the first exercise was most of the warm up, the no-fit snatch. Now we'll do no-fit snatch. We put 50%. I will assume that I will work a bit easier. I will put 70 on the bar and I will do the no-fit snatch. Completed the no-fit snatch.
Break. Track your progress.
Three sets. Here I have also 2 minutes. And I need to wait.
Go.
In the third set, also if you see here in the left corner the timer is going, and it will track the time that you need to perform on set, and after that
break.
I finish and
track
you
your progress.
See, now I was only performing two reps, a no-fit snatch, and I will tap here two reps. I will now a bit further with that.
Go. Break.
Because I want to show you
Go.
The next exercise.
Break.
I want to show you at back squats. So next one, it's high bar back squats. And here you'll have 4 reps at 60% of your one rep max in back squats. You can see also here the exercise. It's very nice, very easy to use. Let's
Go.
Keep. And now what I recommend you is to type here the pause. You pause the workout and you'll take your time. You can stay more than 2 minutes, 3-4 minutes to recover. You will remove the plates from the snatch. You will prepare for high bar back squats. And here it's not necessary to go for first set to jump directly into your 60% more max. It will be no problem if you take your time. You work two sets with empty bar. You put 70 kilos. You work 30%, 50%, two reps at 30%, two reps at 50%. And after that, you resume the workout and you put 60% on the barbell and you continue the program. It's perfectly fine. So I recommend you to take your time to make sure that you are warm up, and after that you can continue. We'll
Go.
Skip also here the squats.
Right.
Next exercise is snatch pull. Here we'll skip
Go.
The same. Now I finish the program. I finish the training day, and they showed me that total workout time was 19 minutes, but because I was skipping the squats and the pulls and almost the worst of it snatch. But if you'll not skip, it will show you the exact time that it was taking you to make the workout. After that also you can see the training log. You can see what you was doing, that muscle snatch plus overhead squat. You see there where I put less reps, I have accuracy of 90%, and no fits snatch, same. I was putting two reps at one of the set and I have accuracy 95%. High bar squat 100% because I only skip it, and snatch pull same 100%. And after that, we'll show you here as day one. When you go again in 3 days, it will show you that day one is completed, and the next time when you go at training, you need to start with day three. So this is how you need to make one day from the app, from the training app. It's really simple. You only need to be honest with yourself and track the things that you do in training. You don't need to put that you make like it's written in program, but you actually make only 60% or 70% of the training. So it's very important to write exactly what you do, and you can see also the progress like that. You can see exactly where you are, and it will be easier also for me to plan the next months of the training, because I will go lower, go higher with the reps, with the volume, with everything, and I can adapt a program for that will suit to almost everybody. This is the video. If you like, don't forget to share and subscribe. It will help me a lot, and thanks a lot for watching.